Hi guys, Codetutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In the previous video, you have seen how I can create a broadcast receiver which can listen to multiple intents. These intent broadcasts are basically system-generated intent broadcasts. What if I want to create my own intent broadcast and design my broadcast receiver such that it listens to my custom-generated intent broadcast? In this video, we will begin with how to go about implementing this particular scenario. You can see that I have created my broadcast receiver, and the name of the broadcast receiver is my broadcast receiver, and then I have created my own intent filter while registering that broadcast receiver in the manifest file. You can see that I am using the action and the category in the intent filter. You can give any unique string while creating that particular action value. This is your own custom string. It could be anything for that matter. And then you have to give the default category. And now going back to the activity, you can see that when I click on that particular button, I am creating an intent. And then for that particular intent, I am setting the category and action values. And if you observe that the category value and the action value are exactly the same that I have used while registering the broadcast receiver in the manifest file. Next method is send broadcast and pass the intent as the argument to that particular method. This will trigger the intent broadcast. So now let us run this. You can see that when I click on this particular button, the toast message is getting triggered. This particular triggering of the broadcast receiver can happen from any other application. For that, I have created another application. In this particular application, I don't have anything much except that it contains an activity, and that activity contains a button. And on click of that particular button, I am triggering the intent. If you observe, the code is same, exactly the same that I had used in the earlier application. This particular application can also trigger the broadcast receiver that is registered in the another app. Let us see that behavior. This is the other app, and when I click on the send broadcast, it is basically triggering the broadcast receiver that is present in the other app. So through this, you can clearly make out that regardless of where the broadcast receiver is present, once you pass category and action values correctly, your broadcast receiver is always get triggered. However, the problem with this scenario is any app which knows the action and the category value to trigger that broadcast receiver can trigger it. What if you don't want this to happen? You want to secure your broadcast receiver so that any XYZ app need not trigger that particular broadcast receiver. For that, you can make use of an attribute called as exported. When you register your broadcast receiver in the manifest file, declare it with the exported attribute set equals to false. This will prevent the broadcast receiver from reacting to any broadcast intent coming from outside the app. This is one aspect of securing your broadcast receiver. There could be a reverse scenario also. The reverse scenario is you basically don't want any intent broadcast to happen outside the app. What I mean is, assume that app 1 has a broadcast receiver and app XYZ also have a broadcast receiver with the same action and category values. And if a broadcast intent happens, then all the broadcast receiver will get triggered. You don't want that to happen. You want the intent broadcast to be restricted to only app 1. For that, you make use of a local broadcast manager to send the broadcast so that the intent broadcast is restricted to only that particular app and doesn't propagate outside the app 1. So let us see this in a demo. We will see the first part wherein I will set the exported attribute equals to false and rerun the app. Now, when I do the send broadcast, it will not trigger the broadcast receiver from that particular app because the exported value has been set to false. But however, from the within the app, it will get triggered. So you can click on this particular button. You will observe that the broadcast receiver is getting triggered. And if you go to the other app and do a send broadcast, you can observe that the broadcast receiver is not getting triggered because of this value is set equals to false. Now let me make it true, and I will go to the other app. I will create a local broadcast manager. Let me initialize it in the onCreate method of the activity local broadcast manager dot get instance, pass the context, get application context, and then use this local broadcast manager to send the broadcast. And let me run this code. And now when I click on this particular button, the broadcast is is not triggered, even though the exported value is set equals to true, because what is happening is the broadcast is not going beyond this particular application, that is the local BR tester. Why would you do this? Because if you are 100% sure that the broadcast receiver that you have implemented is only for your own application purpose and there is no possibility of that particular broadcast receiver getting triggered from anywhere outside the app, or if you want to avoid unnecessarily triggering the intents outside the app context, then you can use always the local broadcast manager. So what we have discussed so far in the previous videos, including this one, is something called as normal broadcast. Android provides another important type of broadcast called as ordered broadcast. Stay tuned to listen to the ordered broadcast. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.